including, to begin with, the unnecessary, militarily unnecessary atomic bombing of Japan. As a result, your generation suffers all the consequences of this, and you accept that since 9/11, a policy of unending war is a necessary and endurable thing. Policies of torture, detention, drones, and undeclared wars, interfering in the affairs of every country in the world, every country, and declaring unilateral regime change, as if we were gods. This has given us an overwhelming arrogance that lives inside the skin and brain of the power elite in Washington, D.C. The feeling that the state itself has the right over its own citizenry to break the laws as it chooses, and most egregiously violate the Fourth and Fifth Amendments in the name of defending our national security. In doing that, we lose sight that security at any cost is a prison for all of us without end, a panopticon that cows us all to surrender our sense of protest, of individuality, of privacy itself to this anonymous secret state that has eyes on us all. This is the triumph of force over liberty. This is naked fascism. Dress it up however you like. And this has nothing to do with the country I was born in and went to war for as a young conservative man. Please don't ever forget that Edward Snowden was 29 years old when he challenged this system on behalf of us all, just a few years older than you. He's an avatar for your generation. Now, don't be cynical and say, privacy, so what? I have nothing to hide. Because when you're older, you might understand what you're surrendering without knowing it is your greatest secret of all, yourself. I told you I went to four colleges, but maybe I exaggerated a bit, because the fourth college is one you never graduate from. I call it the College of Older Age. It is the toughest of all because it makes you question everything. It teaches those who listen the necessity for ambiguity in life's grayer matters, nothing being black or white. And it humbles us in ways we have never been before. I'm sure in your lifetime, you'll see things we never thought would happen. As we were surprised by these wars, by JFK, RFK, MLK assassinations, the theft of the 2000 election, 9/11, the incorporation of the Citizens United Supreme Court decision, allowing money once again to suffocate our voices. More will happen to you in the same way that everybody through all the centuries feels that theirs is the most important time of all. But I still believe that we've been given a divine blessing to be alive in this world. And I believe the purpose of our journey